Hi guys, welcome back to my channel 32 Happy Teeth. Today we will be discussing removable partial denture, in particular Kennedy's classification system. So let's start the video. Kennedy's classification system was proposed by Edward Kennedy in the year 1923. It is the most commonly used classification system in RPD. This classification system is based on the relationship of the edentulous spaces to the abutment teeth. So the relationship of the edentulous spaces to the rest of the natural teeth which is left in the oral cavity. So the relationship which these two components have with each other, that determines which Kennedy class is your arch. Broadly, Kennedy classification system has four classes, 1, 2, 3 and 4. We will be studying each of the class in detail. So start with the class 1. So class 1 is bilateral edentulous areas located posterior to the remaining natural teeth. In this diagram, you can see that this is the natural teeth which is present in the oral cavity and these are the abutment teeth which we will be using. Both sides of the arches, these are your edentulous spaces. Now this edentulous space is not present unilaterally, instead it is present on both the sides. So this is bilateral edentulous areas which is located posteriorly to the remaining natural teeth. So if you see bilateral edentulous space present behind the posterior teeth, it is your class 1 Kennedy. Now moving on to the class 2. Class 2 is unilateral edentulous areas located posterior to the remaining natural teeth. See, this is very similar to class 1. The difference here is that instead of present bilaterally, it is present unilateral. So the edentulous space is not present bilaterally as it was the case in class 1. In class 2, it is present unilaterally, that is just on one side. You might get confused in class 1 and class 2 that in which case there is bilateral edentulous space and in which case there is unilateral. So how you will remember it? See, class 1, after 1 comes 2. So in class 1, there is both the sides edentulous space. Hence it is bilateral edentulous space, and in class 2 you are left with unilateral edentulous space. Now with this we'll be moving on to the class 3. So the class 3 is unilateral edentulous areas with natural teeth both anterior and posterior to it. In this diagram you can see that this portion is your edentulous space, but natural teeth is present anteriorly as well as posteriorly, whereas in class 1 and class 2 this natural teeth was not present. So it was, if this natural teeth would not have been present here in this case, it would be class 2, yes, because it is unilateral edentulous space. But because this edentulous space is bounded by natural teeth anteriorly and posteriorly, then it is class 3. Now moving on to the class 4. Class 4 is single bilateral edentulous area located anterior to the remaining natural teeth. See, this is your natural teeth and the edentulous space is present anteriorly to this natural teeth. Now, till now we have studied that the edentulous space is present behind the natural teeth, but in this case, that is class 4, the edentulous space is present anteriorly to the natural teeth. Now, this is the edentulous space which is crossing the midline. Okay, so this one, this edentulous space is crossing the midline, so it is single yet bilateral. See, it is on both the sides, but since it is crossing the midline, it is called as single bilateral edentulous space, which is located anterior to the remaining teeth. So now you broadly know all the four classes of Kennedy classification system. So the class 1 is the most common class, whereas class 4 is least common. So the most commonly class which you will see in most of the patients is class 1, whereas the least you will see is class 4. Okay, so this is the four classification of Kennedy. I hope this video was helpful for you. Don't forget to hit the like button and share it with your friends. And also subscribe to my channel and turn on the bell icon. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.